Recently, I've been showing my kid Arnold Schwarzenegger movies, which has led to lots of him running around the house going, "Get to the chopper!" We've been through Predator, Terminator 2, Commando, Twins, Kindergarten Cop, and I started thinking of some other Arnold films to show him. I thought of Red Sonja and was like, yeah, that's not a good movie. I then had a thought. I went over to Wikipedia and looked at all the movies based on Marvel properties. The very early 90s and late 80s had films like the wonderfully cheesy and unreleased Roger Corman Fantastic Four movie, which I actually consider a pretty decent film, considering the budget and that it is most likely an unfinished product. There's the really not good Captain America movie, starring J.D. Salinger's son, Matt, which truly only has one amazing sequence in the entire film, and that sequence is pretty early on. And then there's the Dolph Lundgren Punisher, which is a movie I actually dig. I enjoy this film quite a bit, more so than both the Thomas Jane and Ray Stevenson films. Before that, the critically panned George Lucas executive-produced Howard the Duck, released in 1986, a movie that I personally still love to death. Howard the Duck, the first Marvel Comics film, and I'm sure that all the Marvel fans back in 1986 were so hoping that Howard would be the first Marvel hero on the big screen. Technically, you can go back to the 1944 Timely Comics Captain America serials, but I just can't call serials actual films. They were basically TV shows you watched at the movies. Now Red Sonja? Red Sonja is not on that list. Howard the Duck was released on August 1st, 1986 by Universal Pictures, based on Steve Gerber's Marvel comic character that first appeared in Adventures of Fear number 19, before moving on to some Man-Thing comics, and finally into his own comic. He learned some quack foo. He hung out with the Star Child, the Spaceman, the Demon, and Peter Criss, fought the not-so-menacing Dr. Bong, and he even ran for president of the United States. And oh yeah, here's Beverly from issue 1, kind of dressed like Red Sonja. The Red Sonja film was released July 3rd, 1985, some 13 months before Howard the Duck. Shouldn't Red Sonja be the first Marvel movie and not Howard the Duck? Now, Marvel Comics started publishing Conan the Barbarian comics in 1970. The property was acquired by editor Roy Thomas, who would write the series with art by Barry Windsor Smith. The book at first was mildly successful, but soon became one of Marvel's biggest sellers of the 70s and was continually published all the way to 1993. Red Sonja's first appearance was Conan the Barbarian issue 23. Now, Roy Thomas had read an article in an out-of-print book titled The Conan Sword Book, which mentioned a character named Red Sonja that the article's writer thought would have been a good companion for Conan. Now, both Conan and Red Sonja were created by legendary pulp writer Robert E. Howard, but while Conan was a massive success for the writer, Red Sonja was featured in a little-known story titled The Shadow of the Vulture that was first published in the Magic Carpet magazine. Set in the 16th century, this Red Sonja was a gun-slinging swashbuckler and nowhere near Conan's time, the Hyborian Age, which was set somewhere around 10,000 BC. Roy Thomas loosely adapted The Shadow of the Vulture in a Conan issue 23 and had Red Sonja swooping in to save the day, though she had yet to wear her trademark chainmail bikini armor. The character was an instant success, and soon was reappearing in future Conan issues. Conan the Barbarians issue 3 saw Roy Thomas write the origin of Red Sonja, with her family being killed. Red Sonja was actually forcibly violated, dejected, until an angel appeared to her and gave her the strength and power to become the most kick-ass warrior ever. Red Sonja soon found herself in solo appearances in the pages of Marvel Feature, now wearing that very well-known costume that really can't be all that comfortable. Those comics proved to be a massive success, and the character would soon graduate to her very own Red Sonja title, where she would continue her adventures. These comics always gave Robert E. Howard his due. As they said, the book and the character were freely adapted from the Howard short story. There is no mention of Marvel Comics, Roy Thomas, or Barry Windsor Smith in the Red Sonja movie. The movie simply tells us that it is based on the character created by Robert E. Howard. If you look at the Marvel Comics adaptation, you will see that Howard is credited as the soul and inspiration, that Red Sonja Corporation is the owner of the character. You see Mary Wilshire and Louise Simonson adapted the screenplay for the comic and, well, that's it. But watch the movie and what do you see? Red Sonja's family killed. Red Sonja, dejected. Red Sonja, visited by an angel. Red Sonja becomes a badass. She fights John Matrix and then goes on to save the day. The story sounds familiar, right? I wonder where they got the idea for that screenplay from. It seems like creating characters in licensed comic books can be a bit tricky. Take Micronauts, for instance. The MeeGo toy line became a long-running Marvel comic book series. The license has since been picked up by different comic companies, and there have been new Micronauts comics in recent years from Image and IDW. But the character of Bug is not a part of those series. Bug was created by Bill Mantlo and Michael Golden for the Marvel Micronauts series, but remains a part of the Marvel Universe, at one point getting his own one-shot and even joining up with the modern-day Guardians of the Galaxy. Bug was created for a licensed property, but remained the property of Marvel. Let's look at another Roy Thomas creation that appeared in the pages of Star Wars. Now, Jackson was a big green bunny who also doubled as a merc and smuggler in these early Marvel Star Wars comics. Created with artist Howard Chaykin, the character did not make a big splash and faded away pretty quickly. This was probably because of popularity or the lack thereof. The character does not belong to Marvel and is considered a Star Wars character in their expanded universe. Jackson did appear in the Dark Horse trade paperbacks that reprinted the Marvel series and has been seen a few brief appearances over the years, like in Jeffrey Brown's Darth Vader and Friends book and a few variant covers on the new Marvel series. He's even in the Clone Wars cartoon. Well, his dead body is anyway. Jackson was created for a licensed property and remained part of that property and not the property of Marvel. A few years back, writer and columnist Brian Cronin talked about Red Sonja in his column over at CBR. His readers wanted to know why Marvel didn't own Red Sonja. Cronin pointed out that Marvel was more than happy to say that Red Sonja was based on the character by Howard, and not her own distinct character. It seems that Marvel could have gotten the copyright to Red Sonja, they just chose not to. Now, while Red Sonja was adapted from Shadow of the Vulture, which was set in the 16th century, it was Roy Thomas who brought the character to life, brought her backwards in time to the Hyborian Age, who wrote her origins and her adventures, and who gave Sonja her trademark armor. Well, who's better to tell you about this all than Brian Cronin himself?
Likely, Marvel was selling enough Conan comics that they did not want to piss off Conan Properties International on a legal fight that they would not even definitely have won. And Thomas and Winsor Smith likely would not have gained any notable rights themselves under the work-for-hire concept. So they did not have major financial incentives of their own to try to get Red Sonja from Marvel. Plus, Thomas might very well not have even really considered the idea. So the issue was moot from the start.
The very simple answer to this all is Howard the Duck is the first Marvel movie and not Red Sonja. Red Sonja is a character owned by Red Sonja Corporation. The character is still printed today over in the pages of Dynamite Comics. But let's be honest here. The character as we know it was created by a Marvel writer and a Marvel artist. If Roy Thomas and Barry Windsor Smith didn't create her, there is no Robert E. Howard story to go back to where you could find a red-headed, steel bikini swordswoman fighting in the Hyborian Age. It doesn't exist because Howard didn't create it. While there was a Red Sonja Howard character, our Red Sonja was created by Thomas and Smith, given an origin, given life, and the duo never get credit. They never get a mention. There is no special thanks to Roy or Barry in the comics, even right up to this very day. Why? Is it that hard to add special thanks? No, it is pretty easy to do, but I guess it is just easier to pretend that the duo didn't create one of the most popular characters of all time. Thanks for watching 2G1. If there's a topic you would like to see, please leave it in the comment sections below. Special thanks to Brian Cronin from over at CBR and also Damon Brazzell. Make sure to subscribe.
Yeah.
I'm Ryan from 2G1, and I'll catch you next comic.
Call him Howard the Duck. Yeah, ain't no way to conceal it. With a feather's touch, I love him apart. They call him Howard the Duck. Yeah, if it ain't funk, you don't feel it. And he shot an arrow straight to my heart. They call him Howard the Duck. Yeah, ain't no way to contain him. In a second, he would love you apart. They call him Howard the Duck. Yeah, ain't no way to contain him. That fella with the beak, he stole my heart.